Hello, I'm Joseph D'Onofrio, and you're watching Remember This.
Hi, this is Zion, a kid of Pop, and you're watching Remember This with Denise Boland.
Hi, I'm Bodybuilder Bob, and you're watching Remember This with Denise Boland.
I'm Jack.
And I'm Jasper.
And you're watching Remember This.
Hi, I'm Eban Brown. You are watching Remember This with the Retro Queen, Denise Boland.
Welcome to the first episode of Remember This in 2017. I'm your host, Denise Boland, and I'm here with my lovely co-host, Helene Bacheri.
Thanks, Denise.
It's great to be back here with you.
It's great to be back here with you, too.
And a lot of people were happy to see 2016 go.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah, we lost a lot of celebrities in 2016.
We sure did.
Yeah.
So when the time comes, the boy must die.
Right now, in person, she is with us in the guise of her alter ego, Carrie Fisher. Good morning.
So you get nothing. You lose. Good day, sir.
My agent called and said, they're doing this new series, they want you to come down to Paramount and read for it.
That's right, you heard it, okay? What did you say? What did you just say?
You called him a fat fuck.
I'm gonna float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. George can't hit what his hands can't see.
Searching for music is like searching for God. They're very similar. There's an effort to reclaim the unmentionable, the unsayable, the unseeable, the unspeakable, all those things.
Just to name a few, George Michael, Carrie Fisher,
Debbie Reynolds.
The very next day.
Yeah. Really sad.
So
we lost our Princess Leia.
Yes, we did. But we just heard news of another celebrity lost this year is Mary Tyler Moore, who we all grew up with. Mary Tyler Moore, and that was a tremendous loss to find out that she's gone.
Yeah, that was pretty surprising. I mean, she was 80 years old. Which I think is too young.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Well, Betty White is 95, so. Yeah, thank God.
We love Betty White.
But, but Mary, you know, I did some research on her, and Mary grew up in Brooklyn. I'm from Brooklyn. Yeah.
Me too.
Here from Brooklyn. And she moved to California when she was 8. She had kind of like a hard childhood. Her mother was an alcoholic. Her father wasn't really there for her. But she loved dancing. So she started out her career as a dancer. She did commercials. She was the happy hot point elf. She danced for appliances during the Ozzie and Harriet show. And then she went from there to the Dick Van Dyke Show. All right, she was Laura Petrie. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, she was really known for her role as Mary Richards in Mary Tyler Moore, the Mary Tyler Moore Show.
Yeah.
She'll be missed. Yeah, but one thing that I found out that I thought was interesting, the song Love Is All Around, the intro to the Mary Tyler Moore Show, it had two different versions. So the first season, they had a composer, Sonny Curtis, come into the studio. He wrote a song for the show. And so the first version was kind of like, didn't have much hope in it, you know, and we're going to sing the first version for you, and then we're going to sing the second version so you can see the difference.
Excuse me, people, I have a cold today, so.
You'll be fine. Okay, so now the very first season of the Mary Tyler Moore Show opens with this. Ready?
Yep.
How will you make it on your own? This world is awfully big. Girl, this time you're all alone. But it's time you started living. It's time you let someone else do some giving. Love is all around, no need to waste it. You can never tell, why don't you take it? You might just make it after all. You might just make it after all. Okay, so James Brooks, this is good stuff, this is good stuff. Okay, so James Brooks, one of the co-creators of the Mary Tyler Moore Show, called Sonny Curtis back in and said, you know, we need lyrics with more hope because she is making it, you know. She's got the job in the newsroom, she's living on her own, you know, she's doing good. So he came back with the final version, and this is what they played from the second season to the last, the seventh season, and it was... Who can turn the world on with her smile? Who can take a nothing day and suddenly make it all seem worthwhile? Well, it's you, girl, and you should know it. With each glance and every little movement you show it. Love is all around, no need to waste it. You can never tell, why don't you take it? You're gonna make it after all. Da, 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 da. You gonna throw your hat up or I'm gonna throw my hat up?
No.
You're gonna make it after all. Okay, let me take the hat up. And that was on our little tribute to Mary Tyler Moore. We love her. Now we're gonna go and look at her life and career. So we're gonna go to that now.
Laura, will you marry me?
Most people know her from TV.
Say, Mary, that's...
Mary Tyler Moore's two major sitcom roles are emblematic of the way television image of women changed between the early 60s and the late 1970s.
Dick Van Dyke Show.
There was Laura Petrie from the old Dick Van Dyke Show, a stay-at-home mom who brought her own special brand of spunk to the screen. And Mary Richards, the career woman of the Mary Tyler Moore Show. Born in Brooklyn, New York in 1936, Moore was the oldest child of an alcoholic mother and a distant father. She found refuge in dance lessons.
I'm Happy Hotpoint.
Those lessons led to her first job out of high school, appearing in appliance commercials as the Hotpoint Elf. At 17, Moore married Richard Meeker, an older salesman, then lost her job when she became pregnant at 18 with her only son, Richie.
It's no use, Pete. I'm just fed up.
She returned to TV as a guest star on various series until she landed the role of Sam, the sultry, unseen answering service operator on Richard Diamond Private Detective in 1957.
Grab your pencil, Mr. D.
Her big break came in 1961 when she became Dick Van Dyke's TV wife for the next 5 years. She returned to TV in 1970, the Mary Tyler Moore Show, produced by her own company, MTM, led by her second husband, Grant Tinker. As Mary Richards, Moore broke the mold for women in sitcoms. She was over 30, employed, and actually spent the night with a man.
Why are you here?
Well, I haven't seen you in a month or so, and, you didn't think that the only reason that I was here was to...
Instead of a family, she had co-workers and friends.
It's a long way to Tipperary.
In 7 years, the series won a record 29 Emmys. In the late 70s, Moore turned to the stage and the big screen. first as a suicidal paraplegic in Whose Life Is It Anyway on Broadway.
Don't try to change me, Calvin. I don't.
Followed by her Academy Award nominated performance as the repressed mother in the movie Ordinary People. But Moore's private life was in turmoil.
About the early 70s that I began to drink to the point where I thought about it as a solution.
Her son died of an accidental gunshot wound, and her 17-year marriage to Tinker ended a year later. In 1984, Moore checked herself into the Betty Ford Center.
That's a battle that is never won. You constantly say, I am a recovering alcoholic.
Now sober, Moore played lead and supporting roles on television and in movies for new audiences.
I want you to consider my age and ask yourself how I maintain
why are you
this.
Doing this?
Moore, who suffered from diabetes for most of her adult life, was a spokesperson for the Juvenile Diabetes Foundation and an animal rights activist. For fans, she was, in the words of her theme song, someone who could turn the world on with her smile.
Tonight, I am really excited. We have a really great classic rock cover band called Double Cross, and they're going to perform for us. So we're going to get right to it.
Party down, we're an American band. Ow, ow, ow.
let's meet this wonderful American band, Double Cross. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Mike Colonna, lead guitar and lead vocals.
I'm John J.T. Tuasco. I play drums for Double Cross.
I'm Chris Massa. I play bass and background vocals.
That's great. You know, I found these guys because a friend of mine, Angelo Santos, he contacted me and he said, you got to go see my friends perform at, I think it was... Three Jolly Pigeons. Okay, yeah. In Brooklyn, you know, and then
you and I.
Angelo and I went to high school together.
You did.
We hadn't seen each other in years, and then Facebook, you know, just sending out invites and whatever, it came down.
Well, I went to that high school. You went to FDR?
Yes.
What year did you graduate?
83.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, 82 here.
All right.
Yeah. But, so Helene and I, we went to go see them perform.
Yep.
We were blown away.
Thank you.
We were.
Helene kept going, oh my God, they're so good. Oh my God, you have to get them. Oh my God, they're great. Right?
Thank you.
I did.
Yeah. So how long have you been performing together?
Well, the band, Double Cross, the band, we started playing, I guess, in 1997, 98. That's Double Cross. But JT and I have been playing together for since 1994.
Something like that.
So it's been a while.
And I grew up with Cliff. Me and him had bands before the, you know.
Yeah, we go back to the 70s.
He's like my brother.
Me and him.
Band of brothers.
And we're playing, Cliff is with us for a little over
three years. 3 years.
But back when we first started out, he'd come and hang out and watch us play at gigs. So he was very familiar, you know, with what we had done. And he's a dynamite guy. And he fit right in, you know. Perfect.
Like a glove.
That's wonderful. Yeah. And you have the history together.
Oh, yeah.
It's great.
Yeah.
It pays off, you know, because we're all equally insane to some level.
That's it.
There's no egos involved.
No, that's true.
But that's what makes it work.
Yeah, that's what makes it fun.
Yeah.
You know?
That's great. So, all right, so question for you.
Sure.
Wacky question. Okay, so you're at a concert. Somebody in the band faints. They need you to replace them. Which band would you want it to be if you had to fill in for somebody?
Cream. Eric Clapton.
Eric Clapton, nice. What about you, JT?
I have to say Van Halen.
Nice.
Allman Brothers.
Oh, yeah.
Good choices.
Very good choices.
So then if I ask you who your musical influences are, you would say?
It started off with the Beatles.
Of course.
And always will be.
Yeah.
And then it was Clapton for, you know, the lead guitar work and all of that stuff.
Okay.
For me, you know.
How about you?
For me, it was, I listened to a lot of jazz drummers, Buddy Rich, you know, Louis Bellson, and guys that were influenced jazz-wise that mixed it with the rock and the jazz, so it was much more interesting.
That is interesting. Yeah.
You know, not only rock, but it's all a mixture of jazz and rock.
Right.
So that was where I got my style from. Mitch Mitchell, Ian Paice, Carl Palmer, you know, stuff like that. So that was about it.
How about you, Cliff?
Well, the Beatles lit the fire. I'd have to say Jimi Hendrix.
Yeah.
And then Jimmy Page and Led Zeppelin.
Jimmy Page,
definitely.
Of course, Led Zeppelin, yep.
Yes, definitely.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Remember This Tune. I'm your host, Jay Cruz, and tonight we have a big game. It's not just for winning, but it's for bragging rights as well. From the classic rock team, we have Mike, JT, and Cliff. From the soft rock team, we have Frank, Helene, and Poopa. Now, the rules of the game are very simple. I'm going to call upon a contestant from each team. Each member of that team will have one hand behind their back and the other hand over the buzzer. Now I'm going to call upon DJ Mike to play that tune. And when he does, you have to buzz in and guess correctly. Now, whoever does that gets 1 point. There will be 10 tunes that we're going to play throughout the show, and whoever gets the most right wins. In case it goes to a tie, we go to sudden death. And the last point for the team wins the game. Does everybody understand? Classic rock, are we ready? Soft rock, are we ready? So now, everybody at home, are we ready? All right, let's get the show on the road. Give me Mike. Give me Frank. Get back. All right, Mike. Play it.
Mike.
Mike got it correct. 1 point for classic rock. All right. Now next will be JT and Helene. All right. Here we go. The buzzers are right here. That's correct. Okay. All right, Mike, play the next one. All right. Helene, what do you got?
It's Bread. I want to make it with you.
Very good. 1-1. Things are heating up. All right. For the third question, let's have Cliff and Poopa. All right, Mike, spin it. What do we got? Cliff? Sorry.
Brooklyn, no.
You've made me feel so very, very happy.
Very happy.
All right, question four, it's still 1-1. Let's have Mike and Frank. Let's go, DJ Mike, spin it.
Excuse me, but I'd like to be called Mike the DJ.
Mike the DJ, my apologies.
Okay, thank you.
Peter Frampton?
Yeah, yep, that is correct. So classic rock is ahead 2-1. Let's bring up JT and Helene. All right, Mike the DJ, play the next track. Helene, what do you got?
Bohemian Rhapsody, Queen.
There we go. Yeah. All right, things are heating up. This is a close one. All right, so let's go with Cliff and Poopa. All right, Mike the DJ, what do you got for me next?
Well, using my best electronic equipment here, I just got to have to set this up.
Yeah, it's good stuff, bro.
Okay.
I should have gone and looked at all those 45s before.
Are we ready?
Let's do it.
Ready.
Okay.
Oh, God, I know it's Chicago, but what's the name of the song?
Simple and Free?
No. That's incorrect.
Did you get it?
No. Name a song, Just You and Me. All right.
They said it in the song.
Yeah. There we go. All right, folks, so round one is over. So now the second and final round will be a Beatles round. All Beatles exclusive. So are we ready? All right. Mike, Frank, let's do it. DJ Mike, play it.
You could call me Mike the DJ.
Whatever you want.
Within you and without you.
Very good. There we go. Soft rock takes the lead. It's now 3-2. So let's JT, Helene. Helene.
When I'm 64.
Very good. All right. Soft rock is ahead 4-2. Classic Let's have Cliff and Poopa come on up. Yep, 4-2. Last two songs, man, so classic rock, you got to get it. You need two more questions to tie them. This is the way we can go to sudden death. So this is a big one here. You guys ready? You ready?
I'm always ready.
Mike the DJ, play it. Yeah, there we go. All right. 4-3 now. All right, this is the 10th question. So now classic rock needs this to go to sudden death. So let's have Mike and Frank come on up. All right, Mike the DJ. Yep, there we go, got it. Wow, here we go. 4-4, it's now sudden death between classic rock and soft rock. So let's come up, JT and Helene. This is for the win, folks.
Wait, hold on.
All right,
just changing the album.
Okay.
There you go.
What do you got, Helene?
Lizzie in the Sky with Diamonds.
There you go. That's for the wins. All right. And sudden death. Here are your winners. Frank, Helene, and Puka representing the soft rock group. All right, folks. I hope you had fun. I know I did. Let's hear it for a classic rock. Now let's hear it one more time for our winner. It's the soft rock. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, DJ Mike. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Oh, excuse me, Mike the DJ. We had to get that right. Thank you, everyone. I hope you had a great time. Remember to like us on Facebook at Remember This. Once again, I'm your host, Jay Cruz. Have a great night, folks.
Shining through on you. Yes, I'm with you, my love. It's the morning and just we two. I'll stay with you, darling, now. Stay with you till my seat don't dry up. I've been waiting so
favorite Beatle?
It's tough. I would say, Lennon, mainly for the message and the energy, but in terms of craft and longevity, obviously.
Right.
I mean, probably McCartney, you know, but the two of them, not to be boring, you know.
Yeah.
But yeah, it would have to, it would probably be John and Paul, but John first and foremost.
Definitely. I'd have to say Ringo, because he never gets any credit. You know? I mean, he's a tasty drummer. I mean, I listen to, you know, a lot of great drummers, but his, the stuff he does is very tasty, very
underrated. What about Pete Best?
Excuse me?
Pete,
I don't
know.
Do
we remember?
No, I never really listened to any recordings by Pete Best.
Yeah, I haven't either.
Met him about 10 years ago.
You did?
He came out with a book, a little, I guess, about 10 years ago, and he did a signing. And he was, you know, wasn't bitter, you know.
Yeah. But well, for those that don't know, Pete Best was one of the original Beatles.
Yeah.
Then he got replaced with Ringo Starr. So that's good he's not bitter. All these years later, you would get over it, right?
Yeah, and he pulled it off, I guess.
Right.
Did a good job hiding it if he was.
Yeah.
We proudly present the Beatles.
That's what I want. That's what I want. That's what I want.
I'd have to say McCartney, and I was a big fan of Harrison's work.
Yes. My favorite is George Harrison.
George Harrison. I liked him too.
Loved him. I like George too. I mean, yeah, I like Lennon. You know, Lennon is, you know, he's just great. And but George, definitely like George. I like George's style of music.
Yeah.
With the sitar and the whole. Yeah.
You know, he wrote that love song, I guess you call it ballad, Something.
Oh, Something.
Frank Sinatra said that was the greatest love song ever written.
Oh, yeah, so yeah.
That is
yeah.
a beautiful love song.
Great compliment.
Yeah.
And it is a beautiful song.
It's one of the most covered.
And that was written for, Patty, right? Patty. And
George
Eric Harrison. Clapton was with Patty also.
Yeah.
And he wrote a song for her also, So this woman had these two great musicians.
Yes.
Writing these
Fighting
songs
over
for her.
Her.
She had something special going on.
Something.
I couldn't understand was, okay, so she was married to George Harrison.
Yeah.
They got divorced. She married Eric Clapton, and George Harrison went to the wedding.
Well, they were.
I know.
They were buddies.
Well, you thought that would have broke them up a little bit, but
it was
I guess
the
not.
Time, I guess. I guess.
And George Harrison played on Badge, right? He did the keyboard under an alias name, Angelo Mysterioso.
Right,
That's
really?
George Harrison.
Oh.
Yeah. He played the rhythm guitar. And
under the alias name, right?
And the keyboard, I think. And then Ringo was on there too, playing tambourine.
Right.
And the story of that song was they originally wanted to call it Bridge. And when they had the lead sheet out for the lyrics for the producer, it was just the bridge and then the whole structure of the song. And he was reading it. He says, "We need a title for this song." And he saw it, and it was Ringo's handwriting. And he said that he couldn't make it out, and he thought it said Badge. So for years and years and years, they just went along with it.
Wow.
And then when Clapton would play it on his own, he would sing a refrain at the end of the song where he was talking about a badge that had absolutely nothing to do with the song. So,
right. Didn't they form that band? Years later.
Derek and the Dominoes?
No.
Traveling Wilburys?
Yes.
Traveling Wilburys.
That was George Harrison.
That was great. They were great.
But wasn't it Eric Clapton with them?
No.
Who
was
it?
Tom Petty.
What's his name?
Bob Dylan.
And Roy Orbison.
Roy
Orbison passed away, and then...
Yeah.
Right.
Then
I think they... And Jim Keltner.
Jim Keltner on drums, yeah.
Yeah. And then they disbanded after Roy Orbison died, right?
They tried to do.
Because they were so good.
It was great.
They tried
to do a second album afterward. I think they did it, and whatever was in the can, I guess, when they were all still recording the outtakes.
Right.
They put that together.
I mean, how could that band not be good with all those musicians in it?
Oh, really?
Yeah, like top
all the greats.
Guys.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
put your body next to mine and dream on. I've been fucked up and I've been fooled. I've been robbed and ridiculed in daycare centers and night schools. Airports terrorized, sent to meetings hypnotized, overexposed, commercialized, handle me with care. I'm so tired of being lonely. I still have some love to give. Won't you show me? Everybody got somebody to lean on. Put your body next to mine and dream on. I've been uptight and made a mess, but I'll clean it up myself, I guess. Oh, the sweet smell of success.
So now, do you guys only do cover songs, or?
No, we have.
Mike writes a lot of good original stuff.
Do you?
Thank you. Yeah, we play a couple, you know, a handful. A lot of the places that we play it, we try, you know, because they're used to the cover, the bar songs.
That's what
and
they
want to
hear,
is fine.
The songs they know.
You know, and we do a lot of covers, but we approach them in a way where we try and make them our own, you know, improvisationally. I mean, you could recognize the songs, obviously, but we kind of stretch them out a little bit and do our own
thing.
Right.
Make it fun for us, you know, because we've all...
We improvise, and it's, you know, it's
and we
more
throw
fun.
In a couple of
it's
originals.
It's not regimented.
Washed up on the shore, bodies piled up on the floor, needles poking through the ground. Go tell mommy what you found. They don't care, they're showing you no mercy. Mother Nature's dying, I see, but it's black. Don't go in the sun unless you've got a gun, that's what they tell me. I don't listen, yeah. There's danger in the street today. People get blown away. Hide your children, run away, and live to fight another day. They don't care, they're showing you no mercy. Mother Nature's dying, I see bullets flying. Don't go in the sun unless you've got a gun, that's what they tell me. I don't listen, yeah, cause living is tough enough. Gotta live with all of your stuff. Time to recycle your loving. Recycle all your loving, yeah.
A lot of the bands around the regiment that have everything is picture perfect. You know?
Yeah, we're pretty loose. You know, we have a good rapport, which is
that's
like
great.
Like we said,
I was going to ask you about your fan base is pretty decent.
Yeah, they love
like
us.
A lot of regulars coming out.
A lot of regulars
follow you around.
Yeah, a lot of people that have been coming to see us for years. A lot of people that connect with us word of mouth or through Facebook and you know all social media stuff. So it's the best mailing list we've ever had, I guess.
We're up for a Grammy this year. Yeah, right.
Hey, maybe one day. You never know.
We'll see. But we'd like
to hurry up.
But we'd like to do. I mean, we always, in terms of original material, you could kind of break it down that even though we are doing covers, the fact that we do improvise so much and we throw in a little medley of this and a medley of that kind of thing, you know, we're kind of writing, but yeah, we've been talking about it. We want to try and write and record.
You kind of make it your own.
Yeah. But in terms of original material, we have a good handful, but we'd like to be doing a little bit more. We will. Nice.
Like I noticed with the last song you performed, you were going into another song. You started, and I thought you were going to go into that other.
Yeah.
Is that what you usually do?
At times, you know, if it feels right and it sounds right, and we all lock in with each other, we kind of, you know, because collectively, I mean, the three of us collectively, we've been doing this a pretty long time. Mm-hmm. So to be playing the tried and true, you know, or the you can't fail, you got to play this song, you got to play that song.
No.
We've been doing these songs for so long, you know, to keep them interesting for us, having played them for so long, we throw in a little bit.
We step over the line and no boundaries, you know.
We never play the same song the same.
He's right.
But that's good.
You make it your own.
And
exactly.
We tend to weave the songs one into another instead of, you know.
Yeah.
And it's different riffs and stuff.
It's fun because, and as you mentioned, the people that do come down and they see us on a regular or not so regular basis or whatever, they'll be, oh yeah, I heard you guys do this a couple times. And they'll joke with us and say, are we going to hear such and such a song, you know, because we've heard it a million times or whatever. But it doesn't sound
the same.
Right, it never sounds the same because we're always depending on the mood, depending on the crowd, depending on, you know, you get a ticket that day, whatever
it is.
You know, you play it a different way and it'll feel.
Mm-hmm. But even like artists, when you go to a concert, you know, you expect it's going to sound like, you know, what you hear on the radio. And sometimes they sing it completely different.
Unless they're the lip syncers, and then it's exactly what you bought for 18, 20 bucks or whatever a CD. If people buy CDs, I don't buy them anymore.
Right.
But, we have a page. It's Double Cross Live in Brooklyn on Facebook. We're also on Reverb Nation. I'm going to put together a SoundCloud page. It'll be Double Cross, but there is one with my name, but we have a lot of the Double Cross stuff on it. But Facebook, Reverb Nation, SoundCloud, look for Double Cross. One word, the real Double Cross.
Well, actually, I want to ask you how you came up with that band name, Double Cross.
That's a good question.
Oh, Double Cross. Our old bass player, Joe.
He double crossed you?
He had a. No. He had two cross earrings in his ear, and he said, what should we call the name? And he said, Double Cross, like that.
Those
are good. Oh, wow. Spur of the moment.
It stuck.
He had the cross earrings?
Yeah, he had two.
Double, he had two in one.
Was he back in the like days with Madonna?
Dangling.
With the,
No.
But, you know, we didn't put too much stock in worrying about a name. Yeah. And Joe had come up with the name, and we were just sure, why not?
It's a good name.
The more we heard it, you know, and there were blues songs and the whole blues, oh, you double-crossed me, that kind of thing. Then it kind of stuck, and then after a while.
You know, not like Stevie Ray's band, Double Trouble. You know, some people say, oh, it's like Double Trouble. Not really.
Yeah. We're all, you know, we rehearse in a cellar, got all our gear there.
That's our second name, Cellar Dwellers.
Cellar Dwellers.
That's the alias name.
You're gonna mess with me again? Your margarine.
Butter.
What is wrong with you? It says margarine on the label, can't you see?
Butter.
I don't believe you. You wanna mess with me? You're freaking margarine.
Freaking butter.
I can't take this anymore. All you two do is argue every single day. Butter, margarine, butter, margarine, butter, margarine. Oh! That's it. I'm leaving you.
You see what you do? You make me get strangled.
Choked.
I didn't get choked. I got strangled.
Choked?
Look, now she's gone.
She's left.
Oh, man. You know what? I'm going to strangle you. Come here. You want to get strangled? Get... Oh. I'll teach you, okay? Now what are you? Butter?
Butter.
The flavor says butter.
Were you guys in bands as when you were teenagers, like in high school? Were you?
Sure.
Were you in bands? Were you rocker kids in the class?
Like, sure. Yeah, I was. I would get in trouble in grade school because I would either sing or I'd bang on the tables. And then when I was maybe about 8, I got my first guitar and started banging away on that.
You taught yourself, or you?
For about a year or two, and then when my parents realized that it wasn't like a phase. Yeah. They signed me up for lessons.
Lessons definitely help. Do you read music?
I read it, write it, teach it.
That's right, you're a music teacher, Department of Music and Visual Art. Mm-hmm.
So.
That's rewarding.
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah, we're all self-taught.
You're self-taught. Yeah.
Matter of fact, my dad said to me, why don't you take up the harmonica? It's a lot easier. You don't have to carry around all these crazy things, you know?
He does. He
I used to drive my parents crazy. Yeah. Stop that drumming! Stop
my,
that.
My son is a
nuts.
Drummer. I love it. I love hearing him play and.
But it gets to be you tapping.
Shakes.
Even when you're having dinner or something, I was tapping my feet. My mother just stop that.
Addiction. Everything's like. Going. Yeah, right. The house is vibrating when they're down in the basement. And
I went through all of that.
I was in a couple of bands in high school, and then around 1972, I got hired by a wedding band, the Phil Simms Orchestra. As the rock guitar guy, and hooked up with his sons, and then we had a rock disco band.
Nice.
And we worked weddings and all kinds of affairs. I worked with 21 man bands, but I got into the big band music and jazz and stuff, and I was a guitar player. I've only been playing bass with these guys for 3 years.
I've known him for like 20 years. We had a storefront studio, Talk Alone Studios. It was right on the storefront.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah. Well,
thank you guys so much for being on the show. So what song are you going to close us out with?
We're going to play
Beatles song?
A Beatles song.
Yeah.
Oh. We're going to play Back in the USSR.
All right.
Can I give a shout out to my friend?
Yes, you can.
I want to give a shout out to my friend Mike of Maggio Music at 84th Street, 18th Avenue. Thanks for the drumsticks. He's got the best drumsticks.
I know him. I created his first website.
I use SD4. He has the best drumsticks.
Is he the father or the son?
I grew up with Mike, and I know his father, too.
Okay, because I created...
Mr. Maggio, yeah.
Mr. Maggio.
Yeah, he's got the best drumsticks.
Like 1995, I created his first website for him.
Yeah. All the best.
And back then, websites were a little wacky. And I remember someone that worked for him said, can you make it play Smoke on the Water when they come to our website? I was like, yeah.
And Mike, the owner, is a great guitar player.
One of the most underrated guitarists.
He's great.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's great. Well, Maggio Music. Hi, guys.
Thanks again for having us.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here. That's it for our show. I want to thank Helene for joining me.
Thank you, Denise.
Thank you to our guests, Double Cross. Thank you to our crew. Thank you to our studio audience and to our audience at home. Thank you to Donna from Call It a Wrap for providing us with delicious food every time. Thank you, Donna.
Thank you, Donna.
And that's it. Tune in next time. Like us on Facebook. Remember the TV show. Really knocked me out.
Mr. Grant will be back?
I'm Mr. Grant.
You're back.
Look, miss, I was just about to have a drink and I wouldn't mind some company. Want one?
Oh, no, thank you.
I said I wouldn't mind some company.
Oh, all right, I'll have a Brandy Alexander.
How about some coffee?
Well, that'll be fine. Has the job been filled?
Yeah.
Oh.
But there is another job.
Oh?
I figure they hire a man for it.
Oh.
We can talk about it.
Well, good.
Hey, you live in my favorite neighborhood.
Oh, really? Well, I just moved in. Is it that nice?
Nice. Some of the best saloons in town are over there. How old are you?
30.
No hedging. No, how old do I look?
Why hedge? How old do I look?
30. What religion are you?
Mr. Grant, I don't know quite how to say this, but you're not allowed to ask that when someone's applying for a job. It's against the law.
Want to call a cop?
No.
Good. Would you think I was violating your civil rights if I asked if you were married?
A Presbyterian. Oh, I decided to answer your religion question.
Divorced?
No.
Never married?
No.
Why?
Why?
You type?
Mr. Grant, there's no simple answer to that question.
Yes, there is. How about no, I can't type, or yes, I can?
There's no simple answer to why a person isn't married.
How many different reasons can there be?
65.
Words per minute. My typing question.
Yes.
Look, miss, would you try answering the questions as I ask them?
Oh, yes, Mr. Grant, I will. But it does seem that you've been asking a lot of personal questions, which doesn't have a thing to do with my qualifications for this job.
You know what? You've got spunk.
Oh, yes.
I hate spunk. I'll tell you what. I'll try it out for a couple weeks, see if it works out.
Oh!
If I don't like you, I'll fire you.
Right, right.
If you don't like me, I'll fire you.
Yes, yes. That certainly seems fair. Oh, what's the job?
The job is that of associate producer.
Associate?
Something wrong?
No, I like it. Associate producer?
The job pays $10 less a week than the secretarial job.
Oh, that'll be fine.
If you can get by on 15 less a week, we'll make you a producer.
No, I think all I can afford is associate producer.
You can start tomorrow.
Oh, that's just wonderful. So I'll see you tomorrow. Associate producer.
People wearing rubber gloves, too afraid they hide from love. People spreading all disease, you better practice what they preach. Lord have mercy, they don't care, showing you no mercy. Mother Nature's dying, I see bullets flying. Don't leave the sun unless you've got a gun, that's what they tell me. Don't listen, yeah. It's living, it's tough enough. Love your stuff. Time to recycle your loving. Recycle all your loving, yeah. Bring it home in a paper bag. Bring it home, you dump it fast. Bring it home, you take your time. Bring it home, you're all night. Bring it home, bring it home. Bring it home, you got to bring it home. Bring it home, bring it home. Bring your whiskey home.